Hey guys, what's happening? Sam the Beer coming at you, and happy whatever day of the week this is going to be posted is. So as I mentioned in my last Homebrew Wednesday video, we're going to do a little bit of brewery improvements. I'm going to be adding a ball valve to the oil pot here. And so I got the hole drilled. Didn't bother filming it because it's aluminum and it takes all of like 30 seconds and it's really, really soft. So one word of caution, be very, very careful when you're using your hole saw. Because it literally takes no time at all. Then I just smooth it up with the old Dremel-y poo. Won't touch my tongue to that like I did last time because that friggin' hurts. Smooth out the edges and the inside with that. And as you can see, things are looking good. So what I'm going to do is I created my own pickup tube. Now, like I said earlier, the electric brewery is sort of on the back burner for a little bit. Had some unforeseen expenses with the kids' teeth and whatnot coming down the pipe. So that's on hold for a bit. So what I did is I took one of the 90s off of there, grabbed a piece of the copper, and that's actually going to fit like so in there, like that. Hopefully you can see that. That's going to be my pickup tube. Then that stainless steel washer is going to go on the front along with my ball valve, which is right here. Turn on the light so you guys can see. And then I'm going to make my own gasket out of the old silicone baking sheets because they're cheap and those gaskets will last forever. And as soon as they start to leak, you can just make a brand new one. So that's what I'm going to do now. All right, so let's put this piece all together. We'll do a water leak, we'll do a leak test. And then the next thing I'm gonna do today, if I have time, is I'm gonna take my pump, which is there, on that piece of wood, and I'm gonna mount it to the brewery bench here. Right about there, I think. And that's gonna allow me to recirculate my mash instead of vorloffing with the pitcher, and also allow for easier transfer for sparging from the boil pot, which is also my hot liquor tank, which doubles as such. Like I said, electric brewery is on back burner for now, so I won't be using this as an HLT anytime soon. But that's okay. We live, we learn, we adapt. All to make beer. So anyways, you guys, let me turn you off for now. I'll get the old head mount on. We'll take a look-see and see how this thing comes together. Cheers. Okay, so beer in hand, a little bit of Dropkick Nate. Cheers to Nate and Brad from Under the Table Brewing for the recipe. If you guys haven't made it yet, oh, you have to. It's so good. That's my third attempt at it. And it just keeps getting better and better and better. Okay, so now we're just going to trace this out. Bunk. Bunk. And that's going to be the gasket for the inside. Okay, so there's Dunsky. Look at that, eh? Cheap as chips, this is. Cheap as chips. I think this whole pad ran me about $8 Canadian. So that's like, what, 2 cents American? About 4 pounds for all my English friends watching. We're just going to cut it out. And like I said, the beauty of these things is it's cheap. You can buy these rubber gaskets online or from your local homebrew store, but they're going to run you like about $3-4 a piece. Now, I actually got this tip from good old Gash Slug. That's right, Gash. You know who you are, mate. I'm just going to poke it in here. Oh, yeah, silly cigarette. So, hopefully, I don't bugger it up too much. I may have to make a new one because I did rip, but it may seal. We'll see. There. Okay. Attempt number two. Yeah, where's my little doobie? So, yeah, this is going to go inside here. That's going to be my pickup tube. Now, you're wondering, why didn't I go a little bit further? Well, these aluminum pans are pretty darn cheap. And I didn't want to run the risk of blowing out a seam, if you know what I mean. So we're just going to force that down over the threads. Like I said, these are cheap, cheap, cheap to make, ladies and gentlemen. There. It's gonna mushroom out, but that's okay. Once I tighten it down, because it's gonna go in on that side through the pot, that's gonna come out on the outside, and then the ball valve's gonna screw to there. That's gonna go like so. And the ball valve is going to crank around. It's gonna give me a nice, should give me a nice tight seal. I'm gonna need to get the old wrenchy poo out. Wrenchy poo of doom. Nothing wrong with a little bit of channel lock pliers. And hopefully I don't strip the gasket too much, which if I had paid like $3 or $4 for it, I would have been concerned. That's sealing up nice. And because it's soft, there we are. There we are. Ball valve installed. That should give me a nice watertight seal. Pickup tube's there, right where I want it. Now, frig, that looks good. I'm impressed with that. And because it's aluminum, it's very, very soft, but there's no movement in that at all. So I can play with my lever all day long. There. That deserves a victory sip. Cheers, you guys. Okay. So now the mash tun is emptied, rinsed out. It's just soaking in some OxyClean right now, along with the manifold. Whew, I'm gonna drain that. And, I go with these, I love these quick connect fittings. Obviously that's the male end, and you're wondering why I've got a quick connect fitting on, a female quick connect fitting on my pot here. And the reason being is because, just based on the hoses I have, when this pot's full, it's like single hand operation, which is really nice. I just wish there was a way. There we are. Perfect. And we're good to go. And then my other hose is this. So the idea is this is going to connect. Well, when I'm doing my sparging, this is going to connect through that. Actually, no, wait a minute. I'm going to have to get out the pump and I'll show you how it's going to go. But yeah, anyways, there's a ball valve installed. Now we're just going to do a water test. Then we'll do a quick little boil test for 15-20 minutes and see how she does.
Cheers.
Okay, guys, we had a bit of a dribble. So what I'm going to do is, you can see I've removed the ball valve, and you can see where I cranked it down, it sort of indented the aluminum a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flatten the area around the hole a little bit to make a flusher mounting surface. So I'll grab my old trusty 2x4 there and my hammer. Now, 2x4, this reminds me of a joke. This guy walks into a home improvement store and he says to the clerk, he says, "Hey, I need some 2x4s. And the clerk says, "How long do you need them?" He's like, "Well, I need them for quite a while. I'm building a house." So I'm just adding the 2x4 here just to get myself a little bit of a brace to hang on to here. And I'm just going to lightly tap around the surface. Now, you don't have to go too hard, because it is aluminum and it is fairly soft. Just sort of feel around with your finger. Feel around with your finger around the hole. You guys with all your crazy, crazy, crazy comments, give them to yourselves. This is a family rated show. There, that's a little bit better. So now, what the other thing I'm going to switch up is I'm going to put the gasket on the outside. I'm going to slide that jam in right there. A nice little bit of backing with the the nut on that side. And sort of a makeshift. And this is going to fit around there. And we'll also hold it into place. I just sort of want to get it as tight as I can. Where's my pick? There's my pick. If you guys don't have one of these, I strongly recommend you getting one. It's an invaluable tool. And you just slide it. Careful not to damage the threads or split the gasket. Then you just sort of work it around. Work it around, you little bugger. There. Work it around the threads. Nice. So now what we're going to do, we're going to put the washer on the outside. I'm going to soak that down into there. The washer is going to go on the outside. And our ball valve is going to go onto the front. Should probably do it upright. Make life a little bit easier. And we'll just tighten her down. Now this should, by all means, work. If it doesn't, we'll put a gasket on the inside. We'll just hold that down and give her a crank over. Oh yeah, crank her down, you silly bugger. Don't like having a set of water pump pliers. Make sure that is vertical. There. There. That looks nice. Now, as before, you can see it was sort of on a downward angle, and that's because I was deflecting. I had deflected the silicone. But with the washer there is the backing, pushing that washer or the gasket into the pot. That should help me give me a watertight seal. All right, so now what we're gonna do, we're gonna fill this up with some water. We're gonna check for some leaky poos. We're gonna have a sip. Oh man, it's warm down here. And we will hopefully be back with you guys with a positive report. Okay guys, so we gotta fill it up with some water. So far, we are nice and dry, which is cool. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do a quick heat test on this. Crank that up. And we'll see how she does with some heat in the pot, because this obviously is going to be boiling for an hour. And we will come on back. Okay, you guys, so I've been boiling for well over an hour now. And things are nice and dry. No leaks, no drips, no drabs, no nothing. And while I was boiling, I actually took the liberty of adding a leg here and mounting the pump. So what I'm gonna do is, just give this a bash in terms of how my sparge is going to work. I'm going to fill this up with some water. But essentially it's going to be an outflow from the HLT / boil pot. Down into the pump. Inflow is here. Outflow is here with the control valve. Then it's going to go up and around. And into here, which is my mash tun. Now, alright. Let me do some more testing. But yeah. So I mounted the ball valve today. Mounted the pump. And so far, so good. We're going to see what we can do. So let me run the pump lead, and we'll do a quick recirculation shot, not a recirculation shot, but a sparging shot. and we can go from there. All right, guys, cheers. Okay, so I got the pump running. Pump lead is running up and around and up into this power bar here. I got the pump running here, and then the idea is I can restrict the flow based on that and maximize my flow with this valve here wide open, or knock it back for sparging. So I'm thinking what I may do I can knock it back to match the flow accordingly and use that. So yeah, that seems to be working okay. Friggin' rights, boys! Friggin' rights! But I think with the whole oven roasting pan, if I have it sitting over there, I'll obviously have the lid closed, have it just dribbling in, and have perforations throughout the entire thing. I could do a sparge arm. I mean, honestly, I don't really see what the point is. I mean, that seems to be working out a bloody treat. Seems to be working out all right. Yeah, so the outflow here from the HLT / boil kettle is going out from here into the pump. Inflow into the pump, outflow from the pump. The restrictor valve there coming up and around into the cooler. Got a good idea. That's pretty much the same flow. That's what we're looking for there. Just gonna let that run for a cycle or two. But yeah, quite pleased with that. Quite pleased indeed. So anyways, you guys, this has been a really, really, really low-key brewery improvement video. I took the pump that I used to use for my brew-in-the-bag system, repurposed it, mounted it permanently, or semi-permanently, permanently if you will, onto a leg that I just cut the size. And it's running off the HLT, like I said, into the pump, out and around, over into that. The nice thing about this is I should be able to do the exact same thing for recirculation of the mash. So once I get enough liquid in here, I'm going to give that a shot. Be back when that's going on. Anyways, you guys, we'll come back when all of this is done, completed, and plumbed in, and water tested. But yeah, so far, I'm quite... Day two. So I went and picked up a close nipple from the old local home improvement store this morning. I got the female just quick disconnect mounted. And I also picked up the old turkey roasting pan. What it is, I borrowed this idea actually from Polly Detmerds. Hopefully I pronounced your last name right, Paul. And just doing a little test here. This is all full, pump's running, port of flow. Then I'll be able to adjust my flow like so, based on what we got coming in for the sparge. Nice and easy going. But yeah, that's working all right. Working all right. So it should give me pretty good coverage over the grain bed. The nice thing is that's fairly stable. So yeah, I'm going to be brewing up a rye IPA next week. I'm going to give this a shot. But yeah, so far, I would say we're doing all right. Doing all right. Now, the only problem I do have is with this, is getting more of a flow over the entire grain bed for sparging. Just knock that down a hair. Because ideally I'd like to be able to cover the whole area. I'm not sure if this is going to do it or not, but you know, you can see in there sort of how things are going. That's fairly decent indeed. So yeah, I'm gonna try these little tippy poos, give them a shot on Saturday, and hopefully we'll have some good results. But yeah, this I think will work out just fine. I may still pick up some white CPVC and build a whole separate arm assembly that I can securely mount to the underside of the cooler and have it sit over top of the grain bed for sparging. But give this a try, and I think this will work. So anyways, you guys, I want to thank you so very much for watching. Please be sure to like, subscribe, thumb up the video, and share it with everybody that you know. I want to thank you again so much for watching. Please be sure to check out the comments of the guys I have. Be sure to check out the links of the guys I have listed down below. And yeah, we'll go from there. So yeah, it was like $3 for that roasting pan. $3 for that close nipple. Nipple. So yeah, $6 for this and everything else I had. So yeah, we got the pump mounted there permanently. It's running up to there for the power. This is just a nice, easy going, relaxing flow. The only thing is going to be whether or not I have to move that, but we're going to leave it there for now. We'll try our brew day on it and see how we do, but I think we're doing okay. I think we're doing all right. What I may do though is flatten out the top a little bit, or the bottom of the pan a little bit. See if we can do a little bit more distribution over the center. So yeah, I think it's going to work. Anyways, you guys, cheers. Thanks so much for watching. Take care. All the best. And most importantly, please be safe. Thanks so much. Cheers. Take care.